Hello, my name is Ash Bridger. Welcome back to Nero Reincarnation. Now I'm actually. We're just gonna.
What could this black barrier be?
Yes. Every like what the heck? It has like little glitch in there, little lag.
I shall take care of them.
The boy.
Not likely.
Ship.
Firing.
Hey, baby. Wow. This is Hey, y'all, calm down.
How can the enemy be acting outside of the scarecrows? Well, let's just square them away as best we can as we go forward, okay?
Okay. Okay. Yo. Hey, stop it. Come here. You already let down. Okay. There you go. Okay. Back. Auto. Auto. Yeah, go. I have no idea what I'm doing, but I'm having fun.
Enemy forces sighted.
This is a. This is
fatal blow activated.
Shit. Like my team
got enough death for everyone.
There we go. This is actually. I don't know.
What on earth could those dark creatures be after? I'm sorry, child. There are just so many things that Mama doesn't know.
Hey, y'all need to calm down.
Ash, you're a good boy.
Look, something's out there.
Looks cool, at least. I mean, like...
What could it be? There are so many mysteries in the cage, aren't there?
Mm-hmm. And it's only just beginning.
This second scarecrow will hold another part of the weapon's memory.
Done with their hunting, the black-haired sisters decide to return home before dusk.
Oh, yeah.
The younger has caught a small bunny, and the elder a large boar. It is a typical day of hunting for the pair. They only notice the disaster when they come to the hill that overlooks the town. Flames billow forth, and the chilling snaps of distant gunfire can be heard. The woman immediately thinks of the war that is raging in the neighboring nation. She tells her sister to stay put and goes to see what has happened for herself.
Be careful.
The town is oddly still, save for the incessant crackle of flames. The woman gasps as she takes in the grisly sight before her.
Bam.
All she can see are bodies. Bodies. Bodies.
Bodies. A survivor. Damn it.
I'll cut down everything in my way.
Here I go.
I told you that guy's a fucking badass. He's a beast. I love it.
After defeating the soldier, she hears a voice. Her worried sister has followed her into the fires of the village. Enemy soldiers cry out all around them.
For the kingdom. It's just, we have to run.
As the woman feared, the war from the nearby nation has finally found them. Strange and fearsome men surround them on all sides. Impact, heat, pain. Her little sister screams. As the woman's consciousness flickers out, two words from a soldier reach her ears. Sort them.
Sort them. Huh.
I see. This weapon speaks of war. I suppose it's rare for the memories in these weapons to be peaceful ones.
Hey, you don't need to calm down. Stop playing.
Sad.
Come here. Lay down. What? They're leveling up. Now this. Flare. They win. Affiliated weapon. Okay. Well, got out of that ship. Oh. Gotta do another little battle here. There's a lot of fighting, at least, yeah. I don't know if I ever went affiliated weapon. Have your dogs? And chill, can I leave that fam? It was like, I'm down. Something's hitting like the damn piece it.
I shall take care of them.
Going down. Okay. Well, I mean, like, this is pretty cool. I need another level 5, dude.
I have no time for this.
You.
I'm gonna have to go back when I get a wind affiliated weapon, whatever that is. Fun time. These birds aren't supposed to be shooing away. I don't see him. Okay.
I'll cut down everything in my way.
Do it.
Continue. continuing mission.
So, did her older sister die? So many questions. Not enough time.
This room is a bit strange, isn't it? Can you see down there?
Yeah, a lot of shit's a bit strange.
There are so many paths going every which way. It's like a maze. I wonder where the other paths lead.
Nope. Collect whatever this is. Okay. I need to find where the fuck a Wyrn affiliated weapon is. And why the fuck does my chair keep? I need a new one. Shut.
The black-haired woman regains consciousness in a world enveloped by haze. She hears a faint voice.
Wait a minute. Please help me.
It sounds similar to her little sister's voice, but also different. Wrong. My sister. I have to save my sister. The woman's dim memories slowly become clear. The blow she'd taken, her sister screaming, the soldier's words. Her only sister, her only family. She must save her. As she runs, the woman's world is enveloped in a shimmering wall of white.
Yeah, so am I. So.
When the woman wakes anew, she is lying on the floor of an unfamiliar prison. Something is terribly wrong. She looks down at her body and stifles a gasp. One arm and one leg have been replaced by mechanical substitutes. And her black hair is now as white as snow. Where is my sister? She dashes off through the dim prison in search of her missing sibling. She dispatches both her cell door and its guard with equal ease. Only then does she realize the truth. Her body is now a terrible weapon. As this knowledge sinks in, darkness envelops her.
We're gonna have to save her from herself. Dun dun dun! Fine.
I shall take care of them.
Not ever gonna lose.
Let's heal up.
Continuing mission.
I won't pull back. I have no time for this.
Oh, shit, we won.
When she interrogates the dying guard about her sister, he grins madly and says, "Our kingdom will invade all. Every country will bend the knee to our might. Then we'll experiment on the survivors and turn them into beautiful killing machines. Oh yes, they will be sorted. With these final words, the soldier dies. The woman begins to run. Don't think about it. Don't think about it. Don't think about it. She repeats the mantra as she runs, praying that somehow her sister has escaped this fate.
That is sad. Oh, desperately sad. Thank you all for watching. Hope you have a great day, great time, and I'll catch you in the next one.